chamber members that wish to be heard on this particular issue of public transit? Where to go with it, what to do with it? Okay. You're a great crowd. Before we get out of here, I do want to, I'm not trying to put you on the spot, Jim, but since you're the only, like, non-rubber vehicle issue here today, I guess I'm landing here. Tell us, can you give us something brief about what's happening with the airport?
Yes, we have, we've just completed a project that, where we basically tripled the size of the parking area for the airliners. That's about a five-year process from start to finish. In that, 90%, it's about a $3.5 million project. It was done by Reese's Company up in Pehara. And so $3.5 million, 90% of it was federally funded, 5% was funded by Georgia Department of Transportation, and 5% by the people that actually fly out on the airliner that go places. So there was no local taxpayer money involved, but I can tell you that roughly 85% of that $3.5 million was spent right here in our local area. So if you look at the different immediate impacts and the following impacts, it's about a $10 to $12 million economic impact just on that one project that we had there. So there's a lot of rumors flying around, are we going to get bigger jets or more flights or this or that? All I can tell you, with the five-year process that it is, we don't want Delta call up and say, hey, we want to bring a bigger jet in there tomorrow. And I say, well, call me back in 5 years, we'll be ready. So we're basically ready now for the larger aircraft. And our next project we're about to put out for bid later on this month is a passenger boarding bridge. One of the names, people typically call them jetways. That's actually a brand name, but the generic name is a passenger boarding bridge. So the people flying into and out of Valdosta will be just like you go into Atlanta. You won't walk across the concrete out in the rain or wind or anything. And it'll be climate controlled. And so we're hoping that we'll get good bids on that. And so maybe this time next year, when you fly out of Valdosta, you'll be on one of those. And that funding will be basically the same. Our big capital improvement projects are pretty much the same. 90% federal, 5% GDOT, 5% for the people that fly out of the airport. One of the seeds I would like to plant with you all is our control tower and our general aviation terminal, which the general aviation terminal, for those of you who've been here for a long time, used to be the airline terminal. And then the control tower is sitting on top of that building. Those buildings were built in the mid to late 1940s. And they are showing their age. And so they are in dire need of replacement. And it probably made good sense at the time to put the control tower on top of the terminal, but it's a terrible idea today. So what we would like to see is maybe support through either SPLOS or T-SPLOS or nice projects to split that control tower off from and then construct the new control tower. And then in front of the existing general aviation terminal on the grassy area, let's construct a new general aviation terminal there where we split those projects up. And then we can clear that out and meet some other safety requirements that right now we're grandfathered because of the ages of those buildings. But once we get into that, then we'll lose the grandfather status. We can back them up by today's standards or too close to the runway. And so we would like to see that over the next few years. We know it's not going to happen overnight. Even if we were to get SPLOS projects, it's going to have to build over time, and which is fine. We put some money into preserving the roof on the existing general aviation terminal in anticipation of some years down the road with the SPLOS funding or T-SPLOS funding. But it is also, as Ms. Waterman was mentioning, there's other things in T-SPLOS besides just roads, and airport projects are also one of those things that can be funded through either SPLOS or T-SPLOS, as well as maybe other assistance from the state or federal government.
Great. Sounds pretty exciting.
It is.
What was the land purchase about?
The land purchase is we have off the end of the runway, the main runway, which is our north-south runway, there's some parcels of land that one of them contains the most obstructions within the area of the airport of any other piece of land near the airport. And it prevents our aircraft from coming in to go as low as they possibly could in bad weather because of those trees that are there. The owners were looking to sell the property and went through a rezoning process, and it became apparent to us that there may be an opportunity that the airport might be able to purchase this land. It happens to be located in what's called the runway protection zone, and that's not necessarily for airplanes, that's actually for people on the ground because of its proximity to the runway. So there's two parcels. There's a small parcel of the residential part, and then there's also some agricultural land. We're trying to buy both of those parcels of land, a portion of the agricultural and all of the residential part of it, in order to own more of the runway earthquake protection zone and bring it into standard, hopefully have our instrument approach procedures lowered to where airplanes can come in inclement weather. Right now, it's 3/4 mile visibility. The electronic minimum is 1/2 mile. It's kind of pilot geek speak, but what it is, you've got 1/4 mile visibility that we're not being able to use because of the trees on that one piece of property.
Great. Thank you so much. Thanks, everybody, for coming, especially all those that helped make it work.
Mr. Weissman.